Let's look at the answer to our spatial locality quiz. The question is, which memory locations have spatial locality? Remember that spatial locality says that once we access a memory location, we are likely to access nearby memory locations soon. For the variable j, we keep pre-accessing j, but we don't know what's close to j, so we cannot really say that j has spatial locality. If we access j, there is a lot of temporal locality, but not necessarily any spatial locality. Same for sum. We are accessing sum very often by itself, but we are not really sure whether we are accessing anything that is close to sum. For elements of array R, we have seen that there is no temporal locality. Each element is accessed only once in this loop. However, there is a lot of spatial locality. Once we access R of 0, in the next iteration we will be accessing R of 1, and then R of 2, and so on. So it is true that once we access a memory location in this array, we are likely to access nearby locations soon. So this variable definitely has spatial locality. It turns out that the way this program is compiled usually means that there will be some spatial locality between j and sum. J and sum are likely to be allocated by the compiler on the stack near each other. So when we access sum and then access j, that might be an example of spatial locality.